Our Winter Wellness Week continuing this morning with Dr. Zoe Costarellis from Highland Family Medicine. Great to have you in studio. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
So our topic is staying healthy in the wintertime. We're talking about sort of finding ways to stop the spread of those cold and flu germs, if you will. What's a good place to start?
First place to start is just great hand hygiene. Just making sure that you're washing your hands frequently. You can follow the CDC guidelines for washing hands, which is wet your hands, lather them up, and then scrub for 15 seconds, and then dry your hands off. If you don't have water, you can use a rubbing alcohol type solution. Mm-hmm. Make sure it has at least 60% alcohol in it to help kill those germs.
Okay, so clean hands is a big one. What about our immune system? Is there anything we can do to help sort of give our immune system a boost, if you will?
Making sure that you're getting plenty of rest. That's probably one of the most important things. Yeah. Trying to eat a healthy diet. I know that's a little bit more difficult in the winter time, but if you want to kind of stay with local foods, a lot of root vegetables are in season around this time, and making sure that you're still getting plenty of fruits and vegetables in.
What about just being in a clean environment? And one of the places, you know, is the home, right? That's a breeding ground for germs, isn't it?
Yes, making sure that you're cleaning. Try to clean maybe on a schedule. Clean one room of the house every Monday, or and then another room every Tuesday, and making sure that you're using something that has bleach in it, because that will help kill a lot of bacteria and viruses as well.
Okay, and something we talk about a lot in these segments will come as no surprise to you, or you as well, is the flu shot. It's not too late, and it's so important, isn't it?
It is. It's recommended for everyone 6 months and older. Even if the flu vaccine isn't 100% effective at preventing the flu, it still has benefits for getting it. If you do get the flu, it makes the illness less severe and prevents more complications from the flu itself.
All right, all great advice. And we'll circle back to that top one, hand hygiene. Can't underscore that one enough.
Right.
Especially in the winter months when we're trapped inside, the spread of the germs, so it can be so easily transferred through the hands, right?
Yes.
All right, yeah. Doctor, thank you.
Thank you.
If you missed any of our conversation, we're continuing them all week long. Winter Wellness. We're sharing it online. You'll find it at rochesterfirst.com.